And now we will continue our studies of flipping properties by learning about how to record renovations or upgrades. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. How do you record property renovation, also called upgrades, at the moment that you pay for them? Well, all the money you pay for upgrades, regardless of the specifics, should be recorded into one fixed asset type of account. You should not use the sub-accounts to track the separate type of expense upgrades. The total amount in this account reflects the total value that you have added to the home. This may not directly be related to the amount of market value or selling value, but you're still adding value for the amount that you pay. Let's add a fixed asset account. Let's call it Livingston Street Upgrades or Renovations. We will use this account for any type of upgrade that we pay for, and we'll put it in the chart of accounts as a fixed asset. From the main menu, click List Chart of Accounts. Then in the bottom left, click Account New. This is a fixed asset. We click Continue, and we type in the name Renovations, 110 Livingston Street. Now all we have to do is click Save and Close, and now we have the account on our list to be able to use and record anything we pay for upgrades. And now let's continue with our example. Let's imagine on October 10, we paid a new vendor, Handyman Nedgree, to add a room to the house, and we paid him $5,000. So, from the main menu or from the icon bar, we open the check window and we see that that was October 10, 2020. So we fast forward to 10/10/2020. And we don't have Handyman Nedgree on the list. So we click Add New and he's a vendor and we type in Handyman. See if anybody remembers the old Mr. Rogers show or Captain Kangaroo, but we paid this person or this organization $5,000. And what did we pay this person for? We paid them for upgrades and renovations for the 110 Livingston Street. I think it was this one, Renovations 110 Livingston Street. There we go. And we click Save and Close. And if we open the trial balance, you can see for the first time, Renovations 110 Livingston Street shows up for $5,000. Now let's imagine on October 22, we had to pay Con Edison for a special private rewiring job of the house's electrical system, and we paid $4,000. Well, that still counts as renovations and upgrades, so that should be very simple. We open the check window and we switch to October 22nd, the day we wrote the check. We paid Con Edison, the vendor, and we paid $4,000. And you could describe the reason in any way you want, but the bottom line is this is renovations to 110 Livingston Street. So now when we click Save and Close, we can open up the trial balance and we can see that the renovations for 110 Livingston Street is up to $9,000. And finally, on October 28, we paid Rex Repair Shop to redo the roof for $6,000. It doesn't matter what he does, it still counts as renovations. So we would do it the same way. We open the check window and we put October 28, and we choose Rex Repair, the vendor, and the amount we're paying, I believe, was $6,000, yes. Now, You might want to put roofing or something in the memo, but that would be the most detail you could put, because this time we don't want repair expense. This time we want renovations, 110 Livingston Street. Now when we click save and close, we can open the trial balance and we can see that the building renovations are already up to, for 110 Livingston Street, $15,000. And don't worry that our cash is negative. It's going to become positive very, very soon.